Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial online classes, Real Analysis. In this class, we discuss about convergence of alternating series and also conditionally absolute convergence and conditionally convergence topics. Observe that alternating series. The word, it indicates alternative signs, alternating series. A series in which the terms are positive and negative alternatively. A series in which the terms are alternatively positive and negative is called alternating series. It is in the form u1 minus u2 plus u3 minus u4 plus and so on, where un is greater than 0 without irrespective of sign. Observe that the first term is positive. Plus sign, negative sign, plus sign, negative sign. So alternatively positive and negative. Such series are known as alternating series. And it is denoted by the symbol summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 minus 1 power n minus 1 un. It is denoted by the symbol summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 un, which is equals to u1 minus u2 plus u3 minus u4 plus and so on. So, a series in which the terms are alternatively positive and negative is known as alternating series. To check the convergence of alternating series, we use Leibniz test. Leibniz test on alternating series. Or Leibniz test can be used to find the convergence or divergence of the alternating series. Let us see the statement of Leibniz test. The statement of Leibniz test is, if un is a sequence of positive terms, such that it satisfies two conditions, un plus 1 greater than or equals to un. This condition implies as the sequence is decreasing. And also limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to 0. Un is a sequence of positive terms satisfying two conditions. The sequence is a decreasing sequence and limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to 0. Then the alternating series summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 un is convergent. So, it is very, very important test, Leibniz test. Yes, in some class, again, in another class, I can explain the proof of Leibniz test also. If un is a sequence of positive terms satisfying two conditions, one is it is decreasing, means un plus 1 greater than or equals to un. un plus 1 decreasing. The term decreasing means un plus 1 less than or equals to un. Un plus 1 less than or equals to un. It means un greater than or equals to un plus 1. Un greater than or equals to un plus 1. The series is decreasing. And then, limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to 0. Then the alternating series, minus 1 power n minus 1, un is convergent. Make it a note, make it correction. This is not greater than or equals to, less than or equals to. Un plus 1 less than or equals to. Un plus 1 less than or equals to un. It means un greater than or equals to un plus 1. And limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to 0. Then the alternating series, minus 1 power n minus 1 un is convergent. Now let us see the absolute convergent. A series summation un is said to be absolutely convergent if its modulus is convergent. An infinite series is said to be absolute convergence if its modulus, mod un, summation mod un is convergent. If its modulus is convergent, then we say that the infinite series is absolutely convergent. And observe the second definition, conditionally convergent. This conditionally convergent is also known as semi-convergent, non-absolute convergent. The term conditionally convergent is also known as semi-convergent, non-absolutely convergent. This is very simple definition. If summation un is convergent and summation mod un is divergent, it means they have different behaviors. Summation un is convergent and its modulus is divergent. Then we say that summation un is conditionally convergent or semi-convergent. There is one important property. Every absolute convergent series is convergent. Every absolutely convergent series is convergent. But the converse is not true. Every convergent series need not be absolutely convergent series. But the converse is not true. And again, you observe the two important results. If summation un is absolutely convergent, then the series of its positive terms, and the series of its negative terms, both are convergent. You observe that. Summation un is absolutely convergent. Then the series of its positive terms and the series of its negative terms, both are convergent. Similarly, if summation un is conditionally convergent, then the series of its positive terms, the series of its negative terms, both divergent. Observe these two statements. After this theory, we solve some problems. Briefly, once again, you see them. Alternating series, the series in which the terms are positive, the terms are alternatively positive and negative, is known as alternating series. Its generalized form is summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 un. To test the convergence of alternating series, we use Leibniz test. The statement of Leibniz test is, if un is a sequence of positive terms such that un plus 1 less than or equals to un means the sequence is decreasing. Un plus 1 less than or equals to un, and limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 0. Then the alternating series summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 into un is convergent. Absolutely convergent. An infinite series summation un is said to be absolutely convergent if summation mod un is convergent. If summation un is convergent and summation mod un is divergent, then we say that it is conditionally convergent. Conditionally convergent is also known as semi-convergent, non-absolutely convergent. And every absolutely convergent series is convergent. But the converse is not true. Yes, let us solve the problems. The first one, test for convergence. Test for convergence. 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus and so on. This is clearly an alternating series, given that given series is 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 4, plus and so on. It can be written as summation over n is equals to 1 to infinity un. First of all, represent this minus 1 power n minus 1 into 1 by n. It can be written as summation un. And also the same term can be written as summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 into vn. You observe that here un means minus 1 power n minus 1 into 1 by n, vn means 1 by n. The series can be expressed in this way. You observe that again, I can write completely. Given series can be written as, it can be written as summation un, which is equals to summation minus 1 power n minus 1 into 1 by n, which is equals to summation minus 1 power n minus 1 into vn. Clearly, this is an alternating series. It is an alternating series. Here vn is equals to 1 by n. Vn plus 1 is equals to 1 by n plus 1. Trivially, vn plus 1 is less than or equals to vn for all n belongs to capital N, which implies the sequence vn is decreasing. Also, limit n tends to infinity vn is equals to limit n tends to infinity 1 by n, which is equals to 0. Now you observe that vn, the alternating series, satisfies both the properties of Leibniz test. Vn is a decreasing sequence and limit n tends to infinity un is equals to vn is equals to 0. By Leibniz test, we conclude that summation minus 1 power n minus 1 vn is convergent. Summation minus 1 power n minus 1 vn is convergent. Therefore, summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 by n is convergent. Yes, let us verify its absolutely convergenceness also. Now take summation mod un, which is equals to summation modulus of minus 1 power n minus 1 by n, and n varied from 1 to infinity. This is clearly equivalent to summation n is equals to 1 to infinity 1 by n. Comparing this series with summation n is equals to 1 to infinity 1 by n power p. Here p is equals to 1. By p test, summation mod un is divergent. If summation mod un is divergent, now we prove that, you observe that, therefore, summation un is convergent, but its modulus, summation mod un is divergent. Therefore, we say that summation un is conditionally convergent, not absolutely convergent. You observe that because of its modulus, because the series is convergent, given series is convergent by using Leibniz test. But if we take the modulus of the series, then by p test it must be divergent. Therefore, summation un is convergent, but its modulus is divergent. So we conclude that the series is semi-convergent or conditionally convergent. We cannot say that it is absolutely convergent. It is not possible to say that it is absolutely convergent. Let us verify the next problem. Try to solve and test for convergence. One minus one by three. Test for convergence. The next problem is 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 7 and so on. So the given series is 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 7 plus and so on. We observe that these are odd terms. 3, 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on. Summation un is equals to summation minus 1 power n minus 1 into 1 by 2n minus 1. Take it as vn. Here vn is equals to 1 by 2n minus 1. Vn plus 1 is equals to, it is very simple, 2n plus 1. Very clear, vn plus 1 is less than or equals to vn. Therefore, vn is decreasing. Also, as n tends to infinity, vn is equals to 1 by 2n plus 1, 2n minus 1 clearly 0. By Leibniz test, it is convergent. Therefore, summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 into 2n minus 1 is convergent. What about its modulus? 1 by 2n minus 1, 1 by 2n minus 1. Again, it can be written as 1 by 2n minus 1. 1 by 2n minus 1. Now you verify that this series is convergent or not. Summation n is equals to 1 to infinity 1 by 2n minus 1. 1 by 2n minus 1. Let it be summation n is equals to 1 to infinity something vn or tn, where tn is equals to 1 by 2n minus 1. Take Sn is equals to 1 by n, which implies summation Sn is divergent. Summation Sn is divergent by P test. Right. Let us solve. Limit n tends to infinity. Tn by Sn is equals to. Tn by Sn is equals to n by 2n minus 1, which is equals to 1 by 2, not equals to 0. By limit comparison test, we conclude that summation Tn is divergent. We know that if limit n tends to infinity Tn by Sn is not equals to 0, then both the series summation Tn and summation n Sn are convergent and are divergent together. If summation Tn is divergent, therefore we conclude that summation mod un is divergent. Again, you observe that Summation un is convergent, but summation mod un is divergent. Therefore, we conclude that summation un is semi-convergent or conditionally convergent, but not absolutely convergent. Let us verify one more problem. Test for convergence. Summation n is equals to 1 to infinity. Minus 1 power n minus 1 by n root n. clearly this is an alternating series. Clearly this is an alternating series. Yes, let us take summation un is equals to, let us take summation un is equals to summation minus 1 power n minus 1 divided by n root n, which is equals to summation minus 1 power n minus 1 into vn. Summation minus 1 power n into vn. Here vn is equals to, here vn is equals to, vn is equals to 1 by n root n. Vn plus 1 is equals to 1 by n plus 1 into root n plus 1. Clearly, Vn plus 1 is greater than Vn for all n belongs to Z plus. This shows us the sequence Vn is decreasing. The sequence Vn is decreasing. The sequence Vn is decreasing. Let us find its limit. Limit n tends to infinity Vn is equals to, limit n tends to infinity 1 by n root n, which is equals to 0. Therefore, by Leibniz test, the series satisfies both the properties of Leibniz test, decreasing and limit is 0. We conclude that summation minus 1 power n minus 1 by n root n is convergent. Let us verify its modulus. Now, therefore, we conclude that summation un is convergent. Summation un is convergent. Now, its modulus. Summation mod un is equals to summation minus modulus of minus 1 power n minus 1 by n root n. If it can be written as summation 1 by n root n, it is equals to summation 1 by n power 3 by 2. Comparing with summation 1 by n power p, we get p is equals to 3 by 2. We get p is equals to 3 by 2, which is greater than 1. Therefore, by p test, summation 1 by n root n is convergent. Summation 1 by n root n is convergent. If this series is convergent, therefore we conclude that summation mod un is convergent. Summation mod un is convergent. Therefore, we conclude that. Observe that. And then we conclude summation un is convergent, which implies summation mod un is also convergent. Summation mod un is also convergent. We know the definition of absolutely convergent. A series is said to be absolutely convergent. A convergent series is said to be absolutely convergent if mod un is also convergent. Therefore, we conclude that summation minus 1 power n minus 1 divided by n root n is absolutely convergent. Observe that the convergence and semi-convergence are absolutely convergent. And try to solve the following problems. Verify the convergence of the following problems. Try to solve the following problems. The first one is, summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n minus 1 by root n. And the second one is 1 minus 1 by 3 factorial plus 1 by 5 factorial minus 1 by 7 factorial plus and so on. And third one is 1 minus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 3 square minus 1 by 4 square plus and so on. And fourth one is 1 by 1 into 3 minus 1 by 2 into 4 plus 1 by 3 into 5 minus 1 by 4 into 6 plus and so on. Try to solve these problems by using Leibniz test and also verify them. They are absolutely convergent or semi-convergent. Try to practice these problems.